What's up, guys? John here.
I'm Sharisse.
And we're back with another Cupid's Corner just for you guys. And on Cupid's Corner, if you guys don't know or haven't tuned in before, we like to cover some tips and tricks to help you guys, you know, maybe reignite that relationship flame, you know, get that relationship back on track, or set you up for a very, very successful relationship in your future, possibly.
Yep.
So gathering all these tips and tricks through the years, life experience, and you know, talking to our friends too, because you know, we get some good feedback from them or problems that they're going through or family members and stuff like that. You know, and kind of just blend it all in so you guys get all the good information that you guys need. No more guessing, no more, you know, what maybe should I do in the situation? What can I do in the situation?
Give you some options.
We're gonna lay it out for you guys. And this was some things that maybe you guys shouldn't be doing, right? So this one is the name of this segment should be competitive, but don't be in competition with your partner, mm-hmm. All right? So what does that mean? That means that, listen, whatever we do, we should definitely be competitive, whether it's your job, whether it's a sport.
Dave and Buster's.
You always want to be your best, yeah. Right? And, you know, you guys can compete with anybody else out there. You guys can compete with coworkers, friends, family. You know, when it comes to your partner, you guys can be competitive in some things like we were talking about, maybe Dave and Buster's. You go there and you're playing air hockey or one of the shooting games, one of the racing games.
Always competitive.
Right?
Always.
You should want to be competitive.
It makes it fun.
You know, and that should be a good spirit. You know, some people are like, oh, I'm not really competitive. I don't care if I win or lose. You know, is that real?
Or some of the guys that are out there, right? They get mad if their girl wins.
Oh, don't be a sore loser.
Or some of the guys out there let their girl win. Now, and that's okay. But don't do that like on purpose because... Yeah. Then it's not competitive anymore.
Yes, yes. You want them to do their best. Even when you play your kids and stuff like that, yep. You want to be the best you can so they can learn against you, you know?
Exactly.
If you keep doing lay downs or it's too easy for them, they're never going to learn. They're never going to get better. That's what it is. In my personal experience, playing sports, you always want to play older people, more experienced people. That's how you get better.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't play people that aren't good, you aren't going to get any better.
True.
So that's where, you know, that's where it comes in of being competitive. So you want to be competitive in what you do, right? But don't be in competition with your partner. And let's break that down. Just for an example, the other night we were out talking to one of our friends and, you know, basically he had a breakup with his girlfriend and stuff like that. And it kind of went over like what the issues were. So the biggest issue was they were both event coordinators. Now, the girl was, you know, she's very beautiful and stuff like that. So she probably gets a lot of attention and she does really good events. Awesome. Well, they're both together now. So he does his own events. He started getting a little bit of limelight and then she started getting a little bit upset about it. Like, hey, listen, I'm the star, okay? And you're not. And basically, that's what it broke down to. And the guy's like, well, listen, hold on. I thought we were a team.
Right.
You know, I want you to do better. You want me to do better.
Right.
And that's really what relationships are all about. You want something that's going to compliment you and something that's going to make you better. You don't want anybody worse for you because it's going to bring you down. I mean, that's in any relationship you are, a friend relationship or, you know, a love relationship, romantic or business relationship
yeah,
in terms.
True.
You know, if you get into a business relationship with somebody and they're not as good as you or they're horrible at what they do.
Or they're lazy.
Or they're lazy, it's going to bring you down. They want to make you better. They want to be complacent or you know, be leeching off you per se. You don't want that either. You want something that's going to be compliment you, making you better. So in this relationship, the biggest thing between them was the competition factor where, you know, she thinks that she's the star, he's starting to do his own thing and come up, and she's upset about it, right? Instead, they should be like, all right, well, we're working as a team, maybe we can even do events together and just blow them up even bigger.
That would be smart.
And we're the couple together that does this.
Right.
And, you know, I use me and Sharisse as an example for that because we're together, we are 50-50 in everything that we do, even though I'm the alpha and I rule, but...
I'm the alpha when I'm not around John.
That's right. So, you know, at that point, listen, I still listen to her. You know, I take her advice, you know, I take her feelings in consideration, you know, and where she comes from as far as that goes or what she thinks should be the best. And a lot of people don't do that. You know,
you should, though. I mean, really, guys out there, I know that a lot of guys are old school, you know, like old school Greeks, you know, and or even Indian families or, you know, a lot of cultural background families that are high culture.
Yeah.
A lot of the females, and this is the truth, you know, I mean, I know we're all coming up in the world. Okay, cool.
Girl power.
But let's be realistic. In a lot of these other countries still, you know, I think Chinese, I think they still walk 5 feet behind their guy or whatever it was, or it used to be that way at some point. So, you know, it's nice to know that you have a significant other, your boyfriend, your husband, your fiance, whatever it is, that will listen to what you're saying, listen to your input, and won't just totally disregard it because you're a female or it doesn't matter, or they're going to make the final decision anyway, so you're totally irrelevant. That doesn't make your wife or, you know, girlfriend feel very good about the relationship. So it's, that's really important. I think that's been a big one with us.
And, listen, everybody's different. So there might be some women out there that, that want that, or vice versa. There might be some guys that want that. Yeah. So that's fine. If you're happy in what's going on, that's a whole different story. Mm-hmm. But, you know, like I said, don't be in competition. If you want your relationship to be successful, if you are in competition with your partner in everything when it comes to your love life, business, personal, I think there's going to be some issues there. And you're going to get some friction down the road.
It's coming.
And it's going to, you know, it's going to basically make you guys split apart. People are going to get in your guys' ears. You're going to go ask about, you know, what should I do to your girlfriend or boyfriend, whatever it is. And at that point, they might give you some unsolid advice. And that could be put some things in your head that, you know, obviously that could ruin your guys' relationship or end the relationship at that point.
Yeah.
So it's really big about you guys communicating. So if that is an issue, we always mention it.
Communication is
key.
Say it every episode.
It really is. It really is. So the more you communicate, the better the relationship's going to be. You know, and that might mean that you guys stay together for a long time, or listen, you guys come to terms and maybe it's just not going to work.
Right.
But at least you communicate and you guys can be amicable about things. And that's the big, big thing, I think.
Yeah.
You know, it's out there.
100%.
You know, what goes right along with this, and sometimes it can cause these issues too, is yeah. excessive jealousness.
I might be.
Excessive
I
jealousy.
Might be the culprit of this topic here. I'm not even going to lie.
So, and I'll use their example too, because he did bring this up. So, you know, the girl, she's throwing her events and stuff like that. It's okay for her to hug the guys that came to the party or shake their hands. But when the guy was shaking the girl's hands that he knew and stuff like that, or were coming to his events, it was a problem. Who is that? Who is she? How long have you known her? What's the deal with you guys? You know, all this, he's like, listen, he's like, I just met this girl passing, like, I have no idea, but it's just for the event. I have to go out and shake hands, kiss babies, per se,
yeah.
and, you know, and be the face of this thing. I mean, that's what I do, right? And that's what she does, so she should understand.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's sometimes, you know, when people get a taste of their own medicine, they don't like it too much.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a big thing. They don't think about it until it really happens to them. And then when they go through that, then they're like, oh, this is what this feels like. I don't like this feeling at all. And that's when you guys should communicate again about the things or problems.
That's the resolution to this, is communication. So when me and John first met, because I always like to give you guys great examples, you know, listen, honestly, I'm a very jealous person. Very, 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 very jealous. I mean, just very, I mean, even somebody just looking at him for more than they should, which is about 3 seconds, you know, then I'm going to get upset. I am. So I've come a long way, you know, but when we first met, it was the same kind of thing. You know, I mean, we were still doing some individual things that, you know, required us to, you know, shake hands, kiss babies out on the streets, right? But when we go out in town sometimes, he'd be saying hi to somebody. And I'm like, okay, well, first of all, I didn't get an introduction. Let's start there. All right. Number two, who is that? Okay. So here we go with, you know, if you're going to say hi to somebody, just for guys out there, just as some tips for you guys. If you're gonna say hi to a female, and let's just say your wife or girlfriend is a jealous person, or let's say they're not a jealous person, then maybe this is just for respect purposes, okay? If you are gonna hug and, you know, kiss someone and say hello and, you know, be friends, you should introduce that person to your significant other, not, you know, stand in front of them and be like, you know, like now your back is to them and then you're talking to this other female and you're like, hello, who is this? Well, it's not literally, when we first met, I would move him aside and be like, hi, I'm Sharisse. And what's your name? Who are you? I'd love to know you. So that's how that went down. And that's true. Very, very true. I've come a very long way and I've calmed down just a little bit. But, you know, it's big to communicate because I would tell him after that. Well, when we first met, I wouldn't tell him after. I would actually tell him in the midst of, and then we would get into an argument. See, we're real people. We argue. We get into big arguments about, you know, and this could be a whole nother topic, but not to fight in front of other people. That's a big one. Do not fight in front of other people. Do not start arguments in front of other people. If it's whatever it is, just hold it tight, go somewhere else, in the car, wait till you get home, whenever, to discuss it. And I've learned that over the past 14 years now. So I've come a long way with that. But, you know, I would tell him when I got home, like, hey, listen, you know, I don't appreciate, you know, if you do know. And then a lot of times, you know, if you know this person, why you didn't even introduce them to me, you know? And then he would be like, well, I didn't even know her name. You know, I just, and he was being honest about it most of the time, but he was being honest about it, you know, and I didn't even know this girl's name. Like, I just, you know, she knew me from wherever, at wherever promotion, or we did this event and, you know, in passing. And I'm like, okay, well, that's when you still introduce me. Cause obviously she's saying hello to you. So it can make your significant other feel a little uncomfortable because they don't know if you really know them. So how do you know them? Do you have any history with them? Did anything happen with this girl? Why is she looking at you like this? Why is she being all cute? Because I'm like that. So that's just the truth. I'm being honest. I'm very straightforward for those of you that know me. And then you don't, now you know. But, you know, it's important that you communicate that you don't like that. And then they'll stop eventually, hopefully. You know, and they'll stop and they'll, but, oh, wait, let me introduce my wife or my girlfriend. Like, this is Sharisse. This is so-and-so. And, you know, just go from there because it's important that you do that. It can really make your significant other feel uncomfortable, especially in the beginning stages of your relationship where they don't know who your friends are. They don't know who you know or how you know them.
It's true. Especially nowadays with social media and everything.
Oh,
like
my goodness.
Like when we first got together, luckily it was only MySpace at the point.
We might have had an upper hand because of that, actually.
You know, it was just MySpace. So listen, as long as I was in the top eight, number one, I'm good to go.
Yeah. I made you go through his inbox too.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Jealousy, I'm telling you, was terrible. I've come a long way. But he's helped me come that long way. And you know why? Because he makes me feel secure.
That's right.
And it's important to make your significant other. And this is for girls too. I mean, you flaunt your stuff, you look cute somewhere, you guys are wearing a short dress, heels, boots, you're all done up and you're going out and you go to dinner or you go to the club or you're going to wherever, you know, hold the hand of your man.
You can have some sort of PDA.
Or, you know, just maybe even like put arms together, you know, because then people know you're together, you know, and then it kind of diverts some things that can possibly happen. It will divert that, considering that if they see that you're together, then it's just straight disrespectful if they come forward with whatever.
You know, and I do see out there, like, you know, like some girls, I'm just using an example, guys can be the exact same way. They'll be on their phones taking pictures out at an event, looking like they're by themselves. Mm-hmm. Like, and then even do the video, and like, when the video comes around to the other person,
the guy in the corner,
they like go up high or to another angle just so they don't show them, but they want to show like where they're at. So listen, this is like a red flag. Like, why are you doing this? Like, are you scared to like show me in your video or you know, show people that you have a relationship, you know, stuff like that?
You get cropped out of the photos, guys. You better start thinking.
You know, and I know a lot of influencers out there that want that because they want the image of like, listen, I'm single. So everybody likes him, is attracted to them.
Yeah.
You know, because some people, if they say, listen, I'm married or I have a boyfriend, it kind of detours some of their fans. Who knows? But listen, you're not being real with yourself. You're not helping your partner's security level. You don't want them to be insecure, like she said. And you want to involve them in these different things. So if you're with a person, you should be proud that you're with that person. And if you're not proud, then there must be something else going on or some other alternative thing or arrangement. Because there's arrangements out there.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm not judging that at all. If that's what it is, then hey, listen, God bless.
Whatever floats your boat.
But if you're in a real relationship, it's good to show that your partner's there right next to you and other people. It will detour possible future problems that you may have.
Yeah.
Now, on the flip side of that, I did see some other things out there where people are like, they don't want to post that they have a significant other because they don't want people DMing those people or trying to get in their inbox or try to wreck their relationship because they possibly could have had past problems with exes, mm-hmm. right? And then they're like, oh, I want to share this with this person. Oh, we'll see if this person really likes this person afterwards, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's crazy out there. So I can see it on both sides, but you know, when it gets to a serious point, your relationship, you guys are serious, let's say moving in or whatever it is, you're past the dating point, the honeymoon stage, at that point, you're going to have to show that you got your partner. You want to be proud. So that's really what
I agree.
About. Okay? Yep. So that's going to sum it up for this week's Cupid's Corner. We appreciate all you for tuning in. We're loving the feedback. We're coming, you know, up to a whole bunch of people that come up to us. And
oh
like,
my God, I love it.
We see your show on Sundays.
Like, here so, listen, on ABC.
It's huge.
Every Sunday.
It's huge. And we're very blessed and proud, and we still can't believe it. So you guys keep tuning in, showing us the love. We'll keep giving you guys some great tips and tricks to help you guys out. And we'll see you next Sunday, 11 a.m. And if you don't have this on your cable, make sure you guys tune into YouTube or Facebook for the full show too as well. I'm John.
I'm Sharisse.
And we'll see you next week for another Cupid's Corner.
Bye.